Hi, Randall.
Hi.
Come on in.
Yeah, I stopped by to see if you were still looking for a roommate to share your house.
Yep, I sure am. Ever since I cut back on my working hours to go to school, I've been really strapped for cash.
Oh.
Hey, let me show you the place. Here's the living room.
Oh, it looks like you could use a new carpet. And those stains?
Well, I've had a few problems with some former roommates. I know it needs to be cleaned, but I just don't have the money to do it right now.
Oh. And what about the kitchen?
Right this way. Look, it's completely furnished with all the latest appliances except...
What?
Well, the refrigerator door is broken, a little bit, and it won't shut all the way. It needs fixing, but don't worry, I've just improvised by pushing a box against it to keep it shut.
Great.
It isn't that bad.
Well, how about the bathroom?
Well...
No, don't tell me. The toilet is clogged and the sink has a few leaks.
No, those work fine, but the tile in the shower needs to be replaced and the window needs fixing.
Let me see. The tile? What? The window? Where's the window pane?
Well, that's another slight problem. I put up a piece of cardboard to keep out the rain and the snow, and if it gets a little cold, you can always turn up the heat. Well, you used to, until the central heating went out.
Oh, boy. Hey, I think I've seen enough. I can't believe you survived under these conditions.
So what do you think? You really can't beat a place like this for $450 a month. So it has a few problems, but we can fix those.
No, thank you. I think I've seen enough.
Hi, I'm Bob, and welcome to the show, My Home, Your Home. Imagine that it's Monday afternoon and you decide to step out and buy a few things for dinner before the kids get home from school. You look at your watch. It's 1:30 p.m. and you need to be back in 20 minutes. When you get back, you notice nothing out of the ordinary and everything is just as you left it. Then, as you are looking through your dresser drawer, you notice that the contents are in disarray. You realize that the money that you had hidden carefully at the bottom is gone. Nothing else in the house has been taken. And the only evidence of entry is a dirty footprint through an unlocked window. Sound untrue? Not to our family, because it happened to us. Now, there are several basic steps you can take to avoid being victimized in your own home. First of all, make sure that all of your exterior doors and windows have secure locks. If you recently moved into a new home, you would be wise to rekey all of the doors because you never know who might be walking around with a copy of one. Never leave a copy of the key outside under a doormat, on the windowsill, above a door, or in the mailbox. Burglars are very aware of your temptation to do so, and they will find an easy way in through your carelessness. Second, discourage burglars from even considering your home by keeping your yard well-groomed. Trim back shrubbery and trees around entryways and windows where burglars can conceal themselves. Install bright porch lights in front and in back of your house, and consider investing in a motion detector as well. Also, use a light timer to automatically turn on your interior or exterior lights at times when you're away. Next, set up a neighborhood watch group to patrol the area. Keep neighbors informed when you might be away and have them collect your mail and newspapers if needed. Finally, prepare your family in the event someone breaks into your house in order to avoid serious confrontations. If you hear strange sounds in the house, call the police rather than seeking out the intruder. Having a gun to protect you at home is often not the best deterrent because it can be used against you. Think smart and prepare. Doing these basics will go a long way to securing your home, property, and peace of mind.
Hi, sweetie. I'm home. I'm home.
Oh, hi, honey. Welcome home. How was your day? Well, that's good.
It was terrible. The company's going to lay off about 50 people, and I might be one of them.
Oh, that's nice.
That's nice?
Oh,
you're not even listening.
What?
So, what did I tell you?
You said that the company, something about 60 employees, and you might be one of them, or something like that.
No, that's not what I said.
Oh.
The problem is you never listen. Never! So look, I bought you this book. Here, read it.
What? Now what? Big Egos, Little Ears, Getting Your Husband Out of the Clouds? What's this? What? And you paid $35 for it?
No, you did.
Oh.
I used your credit card.
Oh, whatever. So, what great secrets does the book contain that I don't already know?
Okay, first of all...
Okay, I know what you're going to say.
No, you don't. The first thing is not to interrupt and think you know what I'm going to say. Hold your tongue for once and give me a chance to share my feelings before you come up with some witty response.
Okay, I got it, I think.
I hope. Number two, show me that you're listening. Stop checking Facebook while I'm talking to you. Turn off the TV. Look me in the eyes. Anything to show me that you're paying attention.
Right. So what's for dinner?
See?
I'm sorry, I'm just joking.
It's not funny. And it's not funny. Don't quit laughing and don't tell me what to do to fix my problems either. Most of the time, I don't need solutions. I just need you to listen to my feelings.
Okay. I guess I haven't listened enough.
No. You don't listen very much.
And I haven't shown much empathy.
No.
And, well, how about if I read a couple chapters and then we talk about it? Is that okay?
Yeah. That'd be nice. Thank you.
Hey, what happened? Where's Sarah?
She just came out of surgery.
What happened? I mean, how serious is it?
Well, one of the witnesses said a car hit her broadside when it ran a red light.
A red light?
A red light. And then her car burst into flames within minutes of the accident. But the good thing was some bystanders pulled her out of the car just in time. She does have injuries, though. She has
like what? I mean...
She has a broken leg, a broken arm, a broken nose, some broken ribs... And some third-degree burns to her face and her arms.
So was the other driver on drugs or something? Where is he?
Hold on.
What do you mean?
Just settle down, okay? You need to calm down.
Settle down. We're talking about my wife here.
I know. But I can see you're really upset, and you've got to calm down for a minute, because this is going to be a while, okay? Now, look. It looks like the woman that was driving the vehicle got distracted by something. Or maybe she fell asleep.
Probably using the cell phone or something.
We don't know. The police don't know yet. They're trying to piece it all together. So...
Was the woman drunk or something? I mean...
I don't know. We can't jump to conclusions right now. We don't know. And we just... Right now, we just got to focus on Sarah. So,
okay,
I don't know.
So what's going on now?
Okay. Right before you walked in, the doctor talked to me. She had just come out of surgery. It looks like she's going to be okay. She will recover.
Can I see her now?
Not yet. She will recover, but she's going to be in the hospital for at least a month. It depends on her burns and how fast they begin to heal.
Oh, man.
But she is going to recover. You need to realize that.
I mean, why
did this... It's
going
to be rough.
Why did this have to happen?
I don't know. I don't know why. Sometimes, I don't know. But listen, John. I want you to just calm down for a minute. And I want you to think about something. See the man right over there?
Yeah, that guy?
Yeah. It was his wife that hit your wife. And she's in a lot worse shape. She probably isn't going to make it. They don't know if she'll make it through the night.
Oh, wow, that's hard.
She didn't mean to do what happened. She didn't mean to. Something happened, but your wife will recover.
Oh, that's rough. That's really rough.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, you know, just... Think about it for a minute.
Yeah, I need to do that. But right now, I'm going to go talk to the man. He probably just needs a friend.
Hi, I have a reservation for tonight.
And your name?
It's Nelson, Charles Nelson.
Okay, Mr. Nelson. Okay, that's a room for five and...
Excuse me? You mean a room for $5? I didn't know the special was so good.
No. According to our records, a room for 5 guests was booked under your name.
No, no, hold on. There must be some mistake.
Okay, let's check this again. Okay, Mr. Charles C. Nelson for tonight.
Ah, there's the problem. My name is Charles Nelson, not Charles C. Nelson. You must have 2 guests under the same name.
Okay, let me check this again. Okay, here we are.
Yeah.
Charles Nelson, a room for 1 for the 19th.
Wait, wait. It was for tonight, not tomorrow night.
I don't think we have any rooms for tonight. There's a convention going on in town, and let's see. Yeah, no rooms.
Ah, come on. You must have something. Anything.
Well, we do have some rooms under renovation with just a roll-away bed. None of the normal amenities like a TV or working shower or toilet.
Oh, man. Come on. There must be something else.
Well, let me check the computer here. Ah.
What?
There has been a cancellation for this evening. A honeymoon suite is now available.
Great, I'll take it.
But I'll have to charge you $250 for the night.
Aw, man, I should get a discount for the inconvenience.
Well, the best I can give you is a 10% discount, plus a ticket for a free continental breakfast.
Hey, isn't the breakfast free anyway?
Well, only on weekends.
I want to talk to the manager.
Wait, 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 Mr. Nelson. I think I can give you an additional 15% discount, and I'll throw in a free room for the next time you visit us.
That'll be a long time.
Well, hi, Mr. Brown. How's the apartment working out for you?
Well, Mr. Nelson, that's what I'd like to talk to you about.
What?
Well, I want to talk to you about that noise.
Oh.
You see, would you mind talking to the tenant in 4B and ask him to keep his music down, especially after 10 o'clock at night?
Ooh, who, me?
Well, yes! The music is blaring almost every night, and it should be your job as manager to take care of these things.
Hey, I just collect the rent. Besides, the man living there is the owner's son, and he's a walking refrigerator.
Well,
hey, I'll see what I can do. Anything else?
Well, yes. Could you talk to the owners of the property next door about the pungent odor drifting this way?
Well, the area is zoned for agriculture and livestock use, so there's nothing much I can do about that.
Well, what about the... That! That noise!
What noise? I don't hear anything.
There! There it is again!
What noise?
That noise.
Oh, that noise. I guess the military has resumed its exercises on the artillery range.
You have to be kidding. Can't anything be done about it?
Well, certainly. I protested this activity, and these weekly...
Weekly?
...activities should cease within the next 3 to 5 years.
Hey, you never told me about these problems before I signed the rental agreement.
Hey, Paul. Thanks for coming on this hunting trip with me. When my friend came down with the flu and couldn't make it, your sister wasn't going to let me go alone. You know, for safety reasons.
Yeah, well, as you know, I don't really like to hunt.
That's okay.
Well, I only came because my sister twisted my arm.
Ah, that's okay.
I didn't realize I was marrying into a family of hunters.
Shh. Quiet. I can see some deer down there, I think. You'll scare them away. They have a great sense of hearing and smell, so we have to remain out of sight.
Well, as you know, I don't really eat much meat.
You don't have to eat it. I'll take care of that. Just get ready. As soon as the sun comes up in a few minutes, you can often see the deer down in that meadow. You see that stream down there?
Yeah.
Yeah. We just need to quietly get a little closer.
Dan?
What?
How about if I just wait here and watch? You know, watch our stuff.
No, man. We'll have a better chance of bagging a deer if we're together.
Oh, man. I forgot my ammo back at the truck.
What? What?
What a bummer. I guess I'll just have to sit here and watch.
Are you crazy? Here, take these shells and load your rifle. Take them.
Hey, deer, if you're out there, run.
What are you doing? Cut it out. There's a huge deer in there. He's mine. Watch this.
Run, Bambi!
What did you do that for?
Yes! Hey, why are you reloading? They're gone.
Stand around here much longer and you'll see. Any last words?
Well,
Well, folks, the Cardinals are now down by 3 runs, entering the bottom of the 9th inning with Mark Sosa up to the plate. The bases are loaded. Sosa has gone 0-for-3 this game with 2 strikeouts and a walk. Expectations have been high, and I'm sure Mark has felt the pressure trying to rebound from his 5-game home run drought. Mark is up to the plate. Here's the pitch. Oh, an inside fastball. Strike one. Mark has been batting .279 this month, and he needs one more home run to pass the all-time home run record set back in 1961. And here we go. Here's the windup and the pitch. Oh, a monstrous belt to left field. It's gone, and Mark has just earned himself the title of Home Run King. Thus, the Cardinals have picked up their 70th win of the season.
So, have you found a job yet?
No, but I have a few leads, so things are looking up.
But isn't that what you always say?
Yeah, but this time is different.
Well, what are you looking for this time, then?
Actually, I want to work for a web hosting company.
Well, what would you do there?
Well, in a nutshell, you know, web hosting companies provide space for people to store and run their websites. Does it sound like I know what I'm talking about?
Well, yeah, sort of.
And then, sort of, well, they allow people to run their websites without having to buy or maintain their own servers. And I'd like to work in technical support, you know, helping customers resolve computer-related problems with their sites. And you know I'm a good communicator.
So how's the pay for that kind of job?
Well, most people I know start out with a very reasonable salary. You can earn pay increases depending on your performance.
So, what about benefits?
Oh, the benefits are pretty good. They provide health insurance, 2 weeks paid vacation a year, and opportunities for advancement. And I'd like to work in a management position. You know, sitting back, enjoying the view out of the 20th story window of the office building, something like that.
Well, is there any long-term security in a job like that?
Hard to tell. I mean, the internet is booming, and these kind of companies are sprouting up everywhere, which is a good thing. But just like the dot-com era, you never know how long things will last.
Well, have you ever thought about going back to school to improve your job skills?
Wait, what are you suggesting?
Well, you know, more training might help you land a better job.
Well, are you trying to say something about my current job? I mean, is there something going on here? I mean, what are you saying?
Well, you know, you did drop out of college.
I know, but I don't know. I'm just seeing my current job at McDonald's as a step up.
McDonald's?
Yeah, but, you know, I don't have the resources to go back to school at the moment. However, the job I'm looking at will pay for some classes after I've been with the company for 6 months.
Well, it looks like you have things planned out this time.
If I last that long.
Hi. Thanks for coming to the interview today. It's nice to meet you.
Well, thank you.
To begin with, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. Well, I've always been interested in teaching in a language program like this, and I graduated with a degree in English and psychology 8 years ago.
Oh, really? Both?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then I landed my first job overseas in Japan.
Oh, wow. That's pretty impressive. What did you do there? What kind of work?
Well, I worked full-time for a private language school in Tokyo for the first 2 years, and then I found a job at a community college.
Oh, really? So exactly what did you do in your work there then?
Well, I taught English and culinary arts.
You taught cooking classes?
Well, I know it sounds like an unusual combination, but I completed a program in culinary arts before I got my English and psychology degrees.
Oh, wow. You've done a lot, haven't you?
Yeah.
So, what exactly, how did you teach and what exactly did you do?
Well, many of my students wanted to become chefs in restaurants, or they wanted to start their own restaurants. And in our area, there were many tourist spots. A lot of tourists came to that particular area. And so with English, they would be able to communicate not only with suppliers, you know, things that they needed for the restaurants, food and so forth, but also their customers. And so I taught them English and cooking at the same time.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. That's interesting.
And
so
tasty.
Oh, I bet. So why did you return to the United States? How long have you been back?
I've been back for probably about a year now.
Okay, so what brought you back then?
Well, one of my former students opened a sushi restaurant in town, and he asked me to work with him.
Really? What's the name of the restaurant?
Well, it's called Flying Sushi. Have you ever heard of it?
Yes, I've been there. Their food is fabulous. It's top-notch. It's really hard just to get a reservation there.
I know. And, well, I worked there 2 weeknights, and then...
So 2 nights a week you're working there still?
Right. Okay, uh-huh. And then, but now I want to return to teaching. I've also been working as a therapist at a treatment center for teenagers struggling with depression and other mental health disorders.
Oh, wow. That would be a really interesting job.
It is.
Wow. You have such a wide range of experiences. You know, to be honest, we have 15 people who are applying for this position. You've got quite a background, but why don't you tell me 3 reasons why you would be the best person for this job?
Well, first of all, I understand that different students have different learning styles. And for that reason, I've used iPads, video, music, cooking, drama, role plays, and games to reach every student.
That's good.
And second, I have a background in academic and psychological counseling and advising, skills that are often needed, you know, in working with international students.
Yeah, that could be really helpful.
So, you know, many of them struggle with emotional turmoil, you know, homesickness.
Yeah, coming to a new place.
Right. And so making the transition can be very overwhelming. And
good. So what would you say would be a 3rd reason?
And finally, I speak 4 different languages.
4? Wow. Yeah. What languages do you speak?
Well, I speak Spanish, Portuguese, and Japanese at an advanced level.
At an advanced level. Right. Wow.
And I also speak Arabic at a high intermediate level.
Well, that's very, very impressive. You do have an impressive resume.
Thank you.
What we're doing, we're going to have 2 rounds of interviews. We will contact you on Friday and let you know whether or not you'll be coming back for the 2nd round of interviews.
Okay.
It's been really nice meeting you, and thank you for your time.
My trees. My wife planted those 25 years ago. Get off that ladder.
Listen, even though the trees are in your yard, some of the branches hang over into mine. Well, and I'm getting sick and tired of raking up your leaves and picking up all the branches that fall off during the storms throughout the year.
Yeah, but...
And the walnuts off this tree, they litter my yard and damage my lawnmower when I cut the grass. And my dog eats them, he ends up with terrible diarrhea.
Yeah, but still, you can't cut off those branches.
Watch me. It's completely legal. I checked the city code and law regarding this issue, and I'm well within my rights.
I'm not sure about that. Anyway, it's just not right. You didn't say anything to us about it.
I don't have to.
Yeah, but you could have said something. I mean, anything. I mean, I want to stay on friendly terms with you. But the basic courtesy of informing your neighbors is the least you could have done.
Okay, I'm cutting down your branches. You've been informed. Now stand back.
Hey! Well, don't expect an invitation to our next barbecue or book club.
See if I care. Hey, what are you doing? Stop shaking the ladder. You're acting juvenile now. Help!
Hi there, Diane. No. Okay. Hi, what's up, Di? Okay, here we go.
Hi. It's David, right?
No, Doug, remember? We met at Gary's party last Friday night.
Oh, yeah, now I remember. You were standing all alone at... I mean, you know. We started talking about school and stuff.
Yeah.
How did you know I lived here?
Well, I just live around the corner, and I asked Gary if he knew how I could contact you, and...
And?
Well, I was just wondering if you'd like to go out this Thursday night.
Oh.
Well, there's this real great movie playing downtown at the theater, and I thought, we can't use my car because I was in an accident with this wild man driving this BMW, so I've already checked the bus schedule and...
David...
No, Doug.
Oh, yeah, Doug, I'm sorry, but I have to work that evening.
Oh, really? Well, I thought you said before that you quit your job.
Well, I did, but I found a new one.
Well, how about this Friday night? We could have dinner and then see that movie.
A movie? How boring.
Well, a movie? Yeah, forget a movie.
Anyway,
I'm afraid I have to cook dinner for my family and...
Hey, I love to cook. We could whip something up together. I mean, it would be great.
I don't think that's a good idea. It's just a family occasion and...
Well, hey, are you free this Saturday night? I have 2 tickets to the football game and I thought... That...
Sure, I'd love to go.
Okay.
I've wanted to see a game all year.
Yeah.
My roommate will be so surprised when she finds out I have a ticket for her and...
But,
Oh! And here's my brother. He's a defensive lineman on the team.
Well, he doesn't look too happy.
Ah, he's a teddy bear. But hasn't been the same since someone ran into his BMW.
Oh, let me guess. Red, right?
Right.
Oh.
And it's just that he's a little protective of me since I'm his baby sister.
Hey, well, it's been really nice talking to you, but I have to run. Hey, here are the tickets. Have a great time, and... By the way, can I go out your back door?
Dad. Dad. Dad.
Oh, what? What?
The movie's over. You slept through the best part.
Oh, I must have dozed off during the last few minutes.
Right. You were gone for so long, you should have brought your pillow and blanket. So, what did you think about it?
Well, overall, I'm a little disappointed with the movie. I mean, the story was a little bizarre, you have to admit. I mean, really, how believable is a plot about a captain who navigates his spaceship to the far reaches of the galaxy and encounters a race of frog people? I mean, come on.
I thought it was fantastic. I mean, you have to admit, the special effects were awesome, and the acting wasn't bad either.
Oh, come on. I mean, what about the ship's communications officer? I mean, what did you think about him?
Well...
Wasn't he a little weird to you? He was always talking to himself, and he had that funny hairdo.
Well, he was a little... unusual.
Yeah.
But the ship's doctor was amazing. It was so cool when he brought the captain back to life during one of the battles.
Well, that was pretty realistic. But then the rest of the movie just went from bad to worse, and the photography was so fake.
How do you know? You were snoring so loud, the neighbors probably had to close their windows. It was that bad.
Oh, well, let's go to...
Hi, Mr. Adams.
Ah, yes. You must be Kelly. Thanks for coming.
Here's my card.
Oh, the entrepreneurial spirit. It's hard to find a good babysitter on a Friday night.
Well, I like watching kids, and I need the extra money.
Well, I heard you were one of the best and most affordable babysitters in this area, and...
Well, I'd like to talk to you about my new rate increases.
Rate increases?
You see, Mr. Adams, I've consulted with my financial advisor.
What?
My mother. And she says I should charge more per child since I do cook and clean your house while you're away.
Oh, I see. So what do you have in mind?
Well, as I see it, I'd like to ask $1 more per child per hour and overtime after midnight. Based on my calculations, that's only 10.23% above the going market. And I'm now a certified babysitter with training in CPR.
Oh, I never knew there were courses and certifications in babysitting.
Times are changing, Mr. Adams.
Oh.
I have to figure in expenses for a benefit package to cover college tuition, retirement, and my stock portfolio. Well, I tell my dad what to do.
Oh, now, you're pulling my leg. I mean, how old are you anyway?
Old enough to be a tough negotiator. Dad, can I go to a movie with Sharon?
Yeah, sure. But wait, weren't you supposed to get a report card sometime this past week?
Well, yeah. Can I call Sharon now?
You didn't answer my question. Did you receive it or not?
I love you, Dad. You're the best.
Don't try to butter me up. I can guess that your answer means that you didn't do well in some of your classes.
Well, my English teacher's so boring, and he blows up every time someone talks.
In other words, you're not doing so well?
A C minus?
Oh, well, how are you doing in your Spanish class? You said you like that one.
Well, I do, but I forgot to turn in a couple of assignments.
Oh.
And I had problems on the last tests. All those verbs tripped me up. I get them all mixed up in my head.
Okay, and what about algebra?
I'm acing that class. No sweat.
Oh.
Can I go now?
And how are you doing in history?
Oh, that's my favorite class. Mr. Jones is always passing out candy if you know the answers to his questions.
Great, now I have a bright daughter with tooth decay.
Oh, Dad, can I go now?
You can go if you answer my history question. How old am I?
55?
55? You just failed a math and history test at the same time.
Dad?
Well, okay, but you need to come straight home from the movie, and you need to practice your clarinet.
Oh, I forgot about that grade.
What?
Gotta run, Dad. Hi, how can I help you?
This is a stick-up. Put all the money in the bag, now.
What? What are you talking about? I'm going to get the manager.
Wait, I have a gun.
Where?
In my pocket, see?
What? That's not a gun. That's your hand made to look like a gun.
That's what you think. So don't do anything funny. And don't press any alarms. Nothing. Just put the money in the bag.
Okay. But I only have a few dollars and some loose change in my register.
I don't care. Just stuff it in this bag.
I mean, you could make more money setting up a lemonade stand outside the bank and selling each cup for 25 cents.
I don't care. Give me the money now. Good grief.
Okay, okay. You don't have to get all worked up about it.
Come on.
Let's see. Here are a few ones.
Come on, hurry up.
A couple of tens, some coins.
Come on.
Oh, look, here's an old 1935 penny. Oh. I haven't seen one of those in a while.
Come on, stop the chit-chat and fill the bag.
Okay, okay, cranky, aren't we? Oh, your bag has a small hole in it. Let me get you a new one.
No, small hole, big hole? I don't care. Put the money in your sock if you have to.
Well, you see, I'm still in training as a new bank teller, and my boss is evaluating me today. So I have to do things just right, or the bank won't keep me on.
Oh, come on.
Well, I'll be. It looks like someone's car is being towed out front.
What?
Poor devil.
Oh, boy,
that's sure going to ruin someone's day.
Oh, man.
Oh, so where were we? Okay, before I give you the bag of money, could you fill out this satisfaction survey rating your service today?
Does it look like I have any time for that?
Do me a favor. I'll even throw in an extra lollipop.
Oh, tell me this isn't happening to me. Look, this is supposed to be a bank robbery and not an afternoon picnic.
All right, but I'd suggest you turn around now. Nope. Those nice police officers seem like they want to talk to you or something.
Everything's going wrong for me today.
Hi, how can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to return this sweater for a refund. I bought it a week ago.
Well, first of all, what seems to be the problem?
Well, isn't it obvious by just looking at it? The first time I washed and dried it, the thing shrank at least five sizes. It wouldn't even fit an emaciated snake.
Huh, I see what you mean. But you didn't follow the washing instructions.
Huh?
I think it says here, yeah, right here, on the label to hand wash it and then dry it on low heat.
How was I supposed to know that? The label's written in Chinese. And something else. The stitching is coming undone and the color faded from a nice dark blue to a seaweed green. And what kind of merchandise are you trying to sell here anyway?
Listen, sir, we take a lot of pride in our clothing. What I can do is allow you to exchange the sweater for another one.
I don't want to exchange it for anything. I just want my money back.
Well, I can give you credit on your next purchase.
No.
And since the item you purchased was on clearance...
No wonder.
We can't give you a refund.
A clearance item? There wasn't anything on the price tag or on the clothing rack that said anything about that.
I guess you didn't read the fine print in our ad.
Probably
can't read anyway. Look, here's the ad. And the information about the clearance sale is right here at the bottom on the back page.
Where?
Here.
There? What? That small print? You need an electronic microscope to see all those words, and I want to talk to the manager.
He's not here at the moment.
Look, this is ridiculous.
And anyway, you can only return items with a receipt within 6 days, and unfortunately, that was yesterday in your case.
But your store was closed yesterday because of the national holiday. What a ripoff. Listen, I give up. Your store policies are completely unreasonable.
Yeah, right.
Quality of your merchandise is shoddy at best. And your service, well, is non-existent.
You noticed.
And how do you expect people to shop here?
You did.
Here, take your sweater. You should open up a pet store and sell it as a dog sweater.
Hey, how are you doing?
I guess okay. Kind of.
Yeah, Mom said Daniel isn't doing so well. What's going on?
Well, for some reason, I always thought raising kids would be a lot easier than it is.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it. What's the problem?
Well, for about 6 months, he's been really down, and sometimes I can't get him out of bed in the morning to go to school.
He just seems so depressed. I just can't figure it out.
So this has been going on like half a year?
Yeah, it's kind of on and off, but I don't know. I just thought it would just kind of go away. I just thought things would just, I don't know, get better.
Yeah, that's pretty worrisome. Yeah. I've noticed he's not hanging out with Jared very much anymore. You know, what's he doing when he's up?
Well, a lot of the times he's not up. He just kind of stays in bed. Really? I just can't figure it out. I don't know.
Yeah, that's a big problem. I can see why you're really worried about him. Have you considered taking him to a therapist or a psychologist or anybody?
No, it's probably just a phase or something. I think some kids were picking on him at school, but I think that stopped. He doesn't talk about it anymore, so I guess that's over.
So you're saying he was like being bullied and stuff?
Yes, yeah, but he wouldn't talk about it a lot. I thought it was just, you know, having some problems, and it just kind of would go away.
Well, you know, I don't know about that with the bullying or whatever, but, you know, this has been going on a long time. You really need to seriously address it.
I don't know. His girlfriend just broke up with him, so I guess maybe that's had an impact on him.
Yeah, it has. That explains a lot. Have you looked at his Facebook page lately? He posted stuff. Well, he was posting some stuff, I think it was last night, around midnight. Yeah, talking about how much life sucks, wishes he just could disappear.
Oh.
You know, I can't remember exactly the words he said, but I know that it really, really worried me. Some of the things he wrote are signs of that he might be thinking about suicide.
I just can't figure that out. I mean, kids sometimes talk like that. I thought that was kind of natural.
Yeah, sometimes they do. That's the thing that makes it hard. Sometimes kids just talk like that, but some of them are serious and some of them end up taking their own lives. Some of them really do kill themselves. You know, you do need to take this seriously. 6 months isn't normal. Six months isn't just to act like this isn't just a phase. There's something going on.
So any ideas? What should I do? I'm just kind of at a loss here.
Oh, you know, I was talking to a woman the other day about her daughter. There are crisis numbers you can call. Also, you could go to the hospital and go to the emergency room, and they do assessments there, psychological assessments.
Okay.
It might be kind of hard to get him out to the hospital, to get him out to go with you if you can't even get him out to go to school, but you need to take this seriously.
Yeah.
You could take him down to the hospital, down to the emergency room. So,
I don't know.
You know, it's really important because you've got to get on top of it. He needs you. He needs to know that you really love him, that you're not just kind of ignoring this.
I recently noticed that I just saw some marks on his arms the other day, and I didn't know. I asked him about it. It just kind of looked like some scratches or something. And
I saw those too, and those aren't scratches. They're too deep to be scratches. He's doing self-harm too. These are really serious things, and he's crying out for help. He doesn't know how to handle what's going on in his life. He's really struggling.
You know, about a month ago, there was another boy in school, I think it was about his age, that took his own life.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering if that's had an impact on him.
Don't you think it would have?
Probably. I don't know how well he knew the boy, but I don't know.
Yeah, things like that do have an impact on kids, and you just can't run the risk. He might be mad at you for hauling him down to the hospital, but you need help to find out what's going on so that you can support him and so you can make sure that you're getting him all the help that he can have. These things are serious, and you don't want to look back later and say, I wish I had done that.
All right. Well, yeah, summation, and I'll start looking at it.
All right, thanks.
All right, thanks.
Dear Mom and Dad, this is my fifth day at summer camp. Life in the great outdoors isn't exactly what I expected, but I'm not starving yet, so don't worry about me. I guess I should tell you about what I do every day. First, everyone has to get up at 5:30 a.m. They have this silly old rooster named Harry who loves to wake us up. Next, we have to make our beds and tidy up the cabin before our camp counselor, Jeff, comes to inspect the place. Then we have breakfast around 6:30 a.m.
After that, we have some free time, so I've been going down to the nearby stream to fish for a couple of hours. But yesterday, the only thing I caught was an old shoe and a tree branch. Great catch, huh? Then, when I was trying to swat a mosquito buzzing around my head, I slipped and fell in the stream and lost my fishing pole. That ended my fishing career. Well, in the afternoon, there are different activities we can choose from, like archery, horseback riding, and hiking. I thought archery would be the sport for me until I shot an arrow through Jeff's pant leg. As you can imagine, I haven't been invited back since. In the evening, everyone is assigned a different chore to get dinner ready. Yesterday, I was in charge of cooking the hot dogs, but I accidentally dropped them in the fire, so we had to settle for beans instead. The other kids are always razzing me about it. At night, we sit around the campfire in front of our cabins, sing songs, and tell ghost stories. That's usually fun, but one night, while trying to find more sticks for the fire, I got all turned around and got lost. After about an hour of wandering aimlessly in the forest, I finally found my way back. But no one seemed to have realized what had happened, thinking that I just had gone to bed. A bear or wolf could have eaten me and no one would have known it. I was so beat, I just crashed, out like a light. Well, today is another day and tomorrow I come home, and not a bit too soon. I've learned that camping is just not for me. Love, Brad.
Hello.
Good evening, sir. Is this Mr. Charles Phillips?
Yes, it is.
Well, Mr. Phillips, this evening I'm calling to offer you a special discount.
No, let me guess. You want to offer me a subscription to the newspaper or a great deal on airfare to Hawaii, right?
Well...
Or you want to offer me an unbelievable bargain on flamenco dance lessons.
No, actually, Mr. Jones...
Huh?
Oh, sorry. That was the last guy.
Oh, great.
We want to offer you a free trial membership to our sports club downtown at the introductory price of $39.95.
$39.95? I thought you said free. Listen, I'm not interested.
Well, it includes unlimited access to all our facilities, including the gym, weight room, racquetball courts, and swimming pool.
Again, I'm not interested. I have my own fitness program I do around the house anyway.
Well, this is a once-in-a-lifetime deal.
Nah, like I said, I'll pass this time, and please put me on your don't call list.
Okay, it'll take between 4 and 6 months before your name will be removed from our database.
Months?
You might be called by another representative during this time.
Oh, great.
Have a nice evening, Mr. Williams.
Oh, man.
Hey, Rocky, you've been sitting around all night. Get out and dance with someone like that woman over there.
No way. She looks like the intellectual type.
Oh, come on, man. What kind of woman do you like?
I want a woman who's affectionate and fulfills my every need. Oh. And that woman over there is just not the right type.
Hey, where have you been? Times are changing, and you're never going to find a woman who will shine your shoes and pick up after you all the time. Wake up!
Oh, really? I meet a lot of women like that, but not at this party.
No.
I also prefer a woman who will stay home, cook, clean, and watch the kids.
Okay, but what are your household responsibilities once you get home from work?
Eat, watch TV, and throw out the garbage.
Wait. I can't believe I'm hearing this. In fact... You're never going to get married. I recently read a news report that said 40% of women don't think their husbands do their share around the house, and you seem to be that type.
Well, that's the way I am. But what's your idea of the perfect woman?
Well, I like a woman who's outgoing, caring, and non-judgmental about people's differences. And it bothers me when people think that they're the center of the universe, like someone I know.
Well, that's nice for you, but that doesn't change my point of view. I guess I'll have to go home to a TV dinner and my dog, Rusty.
Hey, and if I stick around with you, this is going to be a long, lonely night. Say hello to Rusty for me.
Hey, what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm having your car towed away for parking illegally.
Officer, you can't do that. That's not fair.
What do you mean it's not fair? You parked your car in a no parking area.
What do you mean?
Look, sir, there's a sign right there that says...
Where?
Right there. It says tow away zone. No parking between the hours of 7 a.m. through 6 p.m.
Oh, that one? Those tree branches are covering it.
Sorry. You're going to have to take that complaint up with the city. I'm just doing my job. I'm just here to uphold the law. anyway, you can't clearly see it once you get out of your car.
But my car was only here 5 minutes.
Sorry.
I had to just run into this building to drop off some clothing at the homeless shelter. Just trying to help people in need.
Sir, the homeless shelter? It's 6 blocks down the road. Anyway, look, here's your ticket, and the address where you can pick up your car is found on the back.
What? $150? That's outrageous! I mean, completely ludicrous!
Sorry, don't park your car illegally.
So you mean that you're going to have my car towed away?
Yeah.
And I'm standing right here. Yeah. Look, how about 2 tickets for a lecture on the history of the English language tomorrow night at the library? Anything!
Sir, it's illegal to bribe an officer.
Wait. Or how about some coupons for a free burger at that restaurant across the street?
You've got to be kidding.
Buy one and get the second one half price.
You know, sir, you probably better leave now. Have a good day.
Freedom Travel, how may I help you?
Yes, I'd like to make a flight reservation for the 23rd of this month.
Okay. What is your destination?
Well, I'm flying to Helsinki, Finland.
Okay. Let me check what flights are available.
Okay.
And when will you be returning?
Well, I'd like to catch a return flight on the 29th. Oh, and I'd like the cheapest flight available.
Okay. Let me see.
Yeah?
Well, the price for the flight is almost double the price you would pay if you leave the day before.
Ooh. Let's go with a cheaper flight. By the way, how much is it?
It's only $980.
All right. Well, let's go with that.
Okay, that's flight 1070 from Salt Lake City to New York Kennedy Airport, transferring to flight 90 from Kennedy to Helsinki.
And what are the departure and arrival times for each of those flights?
It leaves Salt Lake City at 10 a.m., arriving in New York at 4:35 p.m., then transferring to flight 90 at 5:55 p.m., and arriving in Helsinki at 8:30 a.m. the next day.
All right, and I'd like to request a vegetarian meal.
Sure, no problem. And could I have your name, please?
Thank you, and welcome to everyone's favorite game show, Unbelievable Trivia. Today's contestant, Julie Jones, has just entered our bonus round and is trying to win our grand prize, $30,000 in cash and an all-expense-paid 6-day vacation to China. Okay, Julie, in order to win the grand prize, you must answer all 4 of the bonus questions correctly. All of the questions are true or false. If false, you must make the statement true by giving the correct information. If not, you go home with our consolation prize, a fine set of encyclopedias on home repairs.
Oh!
Remember, when the buzzer goes off, you must give your answer. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
The first question. A cat has 32 muscles in each ear.
True.
You are correct. Question number 2. A tuna is the only fish that can blink with both eyes.
True. I mean false. Shark is the only fish that can blink with both eyes.
Correct. Only 2 more questions. Number 3. An elephant has the largest eyes in the world.
I know that one. That's false. The giant squid has the largest eyes.
Super! This is the last question, Julie. The national anthem of Greece has 134 verses.
False. The national anthem of Greece has 158 verses.
You are right!
Did I win?
Yes, Julie. Pack your bags and we'll pack your wallet.
All right!
You're off to China. Well, that's all for today's show. See you next time.
Thank you.
Majestic, serene. Just 2 words to describe the scenic regions of Utah and the Mountain West of the United States. Now, our office offers fabulous 5-day outdoor packages of the state for the adventurous.
On the first day of your tour, visit the capital of historic Salt Lake City, Temple Square, home to the world-famous Mormon Tabernacle Choir, and other local historical sites. Then your tour will take you on a four-day adventure of a lifetime to central and southern Utah, where you will hike and backpack through Arches National Park, Goblin Valley, and Bryce National Park. You'll also explore the magical world of Little Wild Horse Canyon, this very narrow, winding chasm with its steep walls on either side of you will leave you in amazement knowing that it was formed from rushing water and erosion over millions of years. You'll also hike and scramble up to remote Indian ruins, study their history along the way, and learn how to respect and preserve the sites and the wildlife you encounter. You'll also learn the basics in rappelling, techniques designed specifically for the novice climber. The price of your tour package includes local transportation in Utah, one night's lodging in a four-star hotel in Salt Lake City, hiking and camping gear, two meals a day, and your professional tour guide. Transportation from your point of origin is not included. Contact our office between 8 and 5:30 p.m. for more information and current availability on this wilderness trek, and reservations must be made 13 days in advance. Let us show Utah like no one else can.
Dad, can I have some money to buy a Game Boy?
Game Boy? Oh, those are too expensive.
No, they aren't. They're just $25. I've gone $42 before, but Mom didn't let me buy one.
Well, let's look. Let's think of some ways to so that, Well, maybe we can come up with ways that you can earn money.
Let's see. Allowance.
Okay, well, allowance. So how much money can you make a week with allowance? What did Mom tell you?
She said that if you get your work done on time, you can get $1.25.
Okay, so if you get your work done, you get $1.25. Okay, and what are some other ways that you can earn a little bit more money?
Let's see. I could work for people.
Okay, well, maybe you can come up with some odd jobs. What are a couple of things that you could do to earn some money maybe around here in the neighborhood? What about opening up a lemonade stand?
I can try that. That'll be fun.
Okay. What else could you do?
Most of the kids on our block like candy, so I can start one of those.
Okay. So maybe selling some candy. Yeah. And what else?
I could take out the trash every day.
Well, I think you have some ideas. So I guess if you stay long enough, you'll be able to earn enough money to buy something you want. Sound good?
Like a Game Boy?
Something you need, let's say. Happy anniversary!
Oh, thank you! Yeah. These are beautiful. You shouldn't have, especially since our anniversary was last week.
What? Oh, I completely forgot.
Again?
No way, I can't believe it.
Neither can I, but you did.
Oh, how can I make it up to you? Again? Anything?
Okay, let's negotiate here.
Negotiate?
First of all, I want to go on that dream vacation you've always promised me.
You mean to Chicago?
No, to Europe.
Oh.
I want to fly first class and stay at five-star hotels and no more places with broken heaters, leaking showers, and dirty bedding.
Oh, were those places that bad?
Well, something a little nicer. At least once in a blue moon would be nice.
Well...
And, oh yeah. Next, I want to get a new kitchen stove. The old one took its last breath weeks ago.
But we...
No, we're not going to use the outdoor barbecue anymore. It isn't any fun at all cooking outside in the winter with icicles hanging from your nose.
That bad?
Not for you, since you're always watching from inside.
Oh, well...
And finally... I want a new wardrobe. Some new dresses, shirts, pants, earrings.
Oh, but...
And no, I'm not going to wear your grandmother's old secondhand pants again.
Is that it?
For now. So, why don't we grab a bite to eat before we start planning the entire adventure?
But lunch wasn't on the list.
Let's see. Paris, Rome, London. Ooh. Then a short detour to Russia, China, and...
What?
Ooh. And Hawaii on the way home.
Wow. I'd better ask the boss for a huge raise.
Ooh, this is
is so exciting. So where are we going to get married? I know. Up in the mountains, you know that beautiful waterfall? Why don't we get married by the waterfall?
I don't know.
Oh, come on. It would be great. It's so beautiful, and it's peaceful, and it's really romantic. Come on.
I don't know. You know I'm allergic to 32 types of wildflowers.
You'll be okay. Take an allergy pill. Come on.
And I might break out in a terrible rash. Okay.
Come on. Well, let's... I'm sure we can come up with something nice. Come on, let's think about
it. What? We could get married in my parents' backyard.
What?
We just need to move the dogs for a few hours.
No, don't even think about that. Their backyard is really it's in bad shape. And their house is only like right next to the freeway. It's only like half a block from the freeway. It's so noisy. Come on. There's this really nice reception hall only a couple miles away. We can do that. You don't even have to worry about your allergies. Come on.
That sounds expensive.
Oh, it's not that expensive. Just a little bit. And then look, we can have a catering service come, and they serve shrimp and lobster tails. And when my friend got married, they had the best desserts. Come on. And then, you know, for our breakfast, our wedding breakfast, we could go to that Japanese restaurant. Oh, I can't remember. What's it called?
You mean Samurai Sushi?
Yeah, Samurai Sushi. Their food is so good. Come on.
That sounds so expensive.
Oh, but it's okay. It's worth it. Come on, Ron. Come on.
How about my mother's tuna fish sandwiches instead?
Ronald... We can spend a little bit more money than you keep in that old stupid jar on your desk. Come on.
I was trying to save money for the honeymoon.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I've been thinking about that, too. I've been thinking about it for weeks.
Well, me, too. Now, look at this website. We could go to Salt Lake City, Utah.
That would be so cool. They have the best snowboarding and skiing, and their snow. It is the best snow. This time of year would be perfect. They have some really, really nice hotels. Oh, Ron, we're going to love that. That would be wonderful. I love skiing.
I was thinking about visiting some of the local art and natural history museums instead.
What?
Snow skiing just isn't my thing.
Oh, Ron, come on.
You know I don't do well in the cold.
Brother.
Oh, yeah. That's a good idea. Let me call my brother.
No way.
He lives there, and we probably could stay at his house.
For our honeymoon? No.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Wait. Where are you going? Come back. Did I say anything wrong?
Hey, Renee, do you happen to know where the movie theater is downtown? The one near the hospital.
Yeah, why do you want to know?
Well, on Monday, I asked Jennifer out on a date for this coming Saturday night.
Wow, you've really been seeing a lot of her lately. Sounds great. Okay, write down these directions so you don't get lost.
Okay, go ahead.
First, drive down First Street going west. Cross the river and keep going straight until Pine Street.
Until Pine Street, right?
Right. Then turn left, and the movie theater is the second building on the right. It's next to the church.
Second building on the right. Got it. Now, can you recommend any nice restaurants?
Yeah, the Pink Flamingo serves excellent Spanish food.
Well, where's that?
Well, starting from the movie theater, go south on Pine Street, cross 2nd Street, and drive to 3rd Street. You'll see a parking lot on the left side of the street. Okay so far?
A parking lot on the left. Okay, then what?
Okay, then turn left on 3rd Street and drive east. The Pink Flamingo is the building just before the river on the left side. I think it's open weekdays from 10:30 in the morning to 11:30 at night, but it stays open until midnight on weekends.
Okay, I think I've driven by there before. Oh, last thing. Where can I buy some flowers? We're going out to celebrate Jennifer's birthday.
Well, the only florist I know is in front of the stadium on 2nd Street. Try that one.
Great. Thanks a lot.